Nashville, Tennessee, in many ways, needs no introduction. It's a well-known hub of country music and a place that has long influenced not only the music but the culture of the U.S. as well. But there's a lot more to Nashville than just Music Row. It's a beacon of nightlife and live entertainment, a home to a thriving art scene, and a world-class food scene as well. So join Viewcation as we cover the best things to do in Nashville, Tennessee. Robert's Western World. Lower Broadway is a famous area of Nashville filled with honky-tonk bars, and while some of these have taken advantage of the tourist scene by expanding into a more rock and roll vibe, perfect for bachelorette parties and frat kids, Roberts has managed to preserve its old-school roots. While we do recommend bar hopping if you're headed down Lower Broadway, we highly recommend spending some extra time here. Robert's Western World still hires top-notch musicians to play Western swing, and its laid-back atmosphere is perfect for soaking the tunes in. You can sate your thirst with a cold beer, eat a fried bologna sandwich, and just enjoy the festivities. Ryman Auditorium. If you've ever heard of the Grand Ole Opry, then you might have also heard of the Ryman Auditorium. That's because Ryman played host to the Opry from 1943 to 74. In fact, this 2,300-seat venue is seeped in Nashville history, culture, and music. The acoustics in Ryman are world-class, despite it being built in 1892. They certainly did something right in the construction. Inside, there are cool tributes to legends like Minnie Pearl and Roy Acuff. And further in are there exhibits all about Johnny and June, aka Johnny Cash and June Carter Cash, as well as ones on the Opry's early years. If you choose a guided tour, they'll even bring you into the dressing rooms and backstage. There's even a working recording studio inside where you can record songs to take home with you. Of course, since Ryman is a working venue, there are incredible acts all year round. So we recommend planning your trip around a great show. General Jackson Showboat. Cruising around the Cumberland River on the General Jackson Showboat is a great way to get acclimated with the layout of the city. It's also a great way to relax and enjoy a trip on the water. This large paddle wheel boat has four separate decks from which you can look out into the gorgeous Tennessee landscape and take in Nashville without the hustle and bustle of the city. The boat holds 1,000 passengers comfortably, and you can choose either an afternoon cruise or an evening cruise. The afternoon one is 2.5 hours long and comes with lunch, and the dinner cruise is 3 hours. While on board, you'll also be able to watch performers play music as you cruise. The afternoon cruise is themed around Tennessee legends. The evening is focused on the music of New Orleans, early country music from Nashville, and Memphis blues. Before we tell you more about the best things to do in Nashville, be sure to give this video a like and subscribe to Viewcation if you haven't already. Frist Art Museum. While Nashville is far more known for music than fine art, the Frist Art Museum has sought to buck that trend. It was started in 2001 in a building that used to house the primary post office of Nashville. One cool thing about this museum is that there aren't any permanent exhibits. Instead, it's a constant rotation of exhibitions. This could range from Japanese art to old-timey cars and everything in between. The steady rotation is one of the reasons locals love the Frist Museum, the element of change and surprise. They also host a free monthly concert known as Music at the Frist. The Station Inn. While this might sound like it's a hipster hotel, it's actually the premier bluegrass venue in Nashville. And while bluegrass might often be thought of as country music's kid cousin, it's a thriving genre in certain areas and in certain circles. The Station Inn has an intensely homey feel to it. You'll think you stepped into someone's basement to watch their friends play music. But instead, it's a bar hosting some of the most talented bluegrass musicians in the country. There's music going on every night, so you can pop in anytime and hear quality tunes. If you're there on a Sunday night, you'll get a chance to watch the Sunday Bluegrass Jam, which often gets local legends and touring bluegrass favorites all playing together. Lane Motor Museum. This private museum's mission is to show off vehicles from four different continents – Europe, Asia, North America, and South America – from the roaring 20s to today. What's more, all the vehicles are still in proper working order. The Lane Motor Museum boasts a collection of over 150 cars, motorcycles, and amphibious vehicles on a rotating schedule. So, much like the Frist Art Museum, it provides somewhat of a new experience every time you go. And that translates to popularity with locals and tourists alike. Each vehicle has info cards next to it telling you about the history of the vehicle and its particular significance. You can also take a look into the repair garages, where mechanics and curators work to get new cars to the collection up and running again before they're added to the museum. Willie Nelson and Friends Museum. Are you a fan of country legend Willie Nelson? Then this is the spot for you. The Willie Nelson and Friends Museum is dedicated to all things Willie, and it packs a small space with a ton of cool stuff. Prime among them are Nelson's very first Martin guitar, as well as his CMA Award for Entertainer of the Year from 1979. The museum also boasts memorabilia and musical artifacts from some of Willie's best friends in the country music world. When you head there, you'll find assorted things from Nelson's Texas recording studio, including chairs and microphones. They even have Willie's old pool table as well. We recommend taking the self-guided tour. It'll walk you around to see cool displays of Kenny Rogers' concert clothing, some of Patsy Cline's diaries, and more. There are also cases that honor country legends like Porter Wagoner, Glenn Campbell, and more. And grab a souvenir from the general store up front. Hatch Show Print. If you've ever seen the insanely cool posters for the shows at Nashville's biggest venues, then you've seen what Hatch Show Print can do. They've been making show posters for 140 years, so they've printed out cool designs for the biggest names in music across a few generations. It's still a functioning poster print shop, and they make more than 500 new ones each year. When you visit, you can purchase copies of some of the classic ones, such as William Hatch's poster for the Grand Ole Opry that he created in 1941. Hatch Show Print is also a museum, though, so you'll get a chance to look at preserved copies of old posters all over the building, and they rotate throughout the year. If you're a true fan of poster making, you can sign up for workshops and tours. The Loveless Café. Of course, checking out all the activities and places we've listed will leave you hungry. And one of our top picks when it's chow time is the Loveless Café. Technically, this one is 20 minutes outside town, but it's worth it. If you're hankering for an incredible lunch with a home-cooked feel, you can't go wrong. The hot biscuits are the first absolute must order. Not only are they a Southern classic, but Loveless makes some of the best around. They also have a killer Southern sampler platter. It comes with fried chicken, country ham, catfish, and meatloaf, so bring your appetite. Nashville Hot Air Balloon. When you think of Nashville, you might think of country music or Southern cooking, but you probably don't think of a hot air balloon ride. And that's exactly why you should try one, courtesy of Nashville Hot Air Balloon. Up to 6 people can fit in each balloon, and you'll get the chance to float about the Nashville area for around an hour. The balloons go around 500 to 2,000 feet in the air and move at a leisurely 5 to 10 miles an hour. It's a cool and relaxing way to see the gorgeous Tennessee wilderness and the city of Nashville from above. Now it's time to hear from you. Did we miss any of your favorites in Nashville? Let us know in the comments section below. And before you go, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to Viewcation if you haven't already. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.